the biggest difference between someone who is able to join FAANG companies as a product leader compared with someone who is not able to make it happen was the product leadership mindset. It may take someone years to become a product manager in FAANG companies. However, if you master the product leadership mindset, it can become much faster. What is product leadership mindset? It is you behave and think as if you're a product manager before you even go into FAANG companies. So this is our Influential Product Leader podcast series where I interview the product manager from Microsoft, Nikhil, and he's sharing his secret regarding how he's able to become a product manager in Microsoft within 40 days. And I believe all the secret we share with you today is able to applicable to you guys as well. So make sure to take lots of notes and let's get started. Hey guys, this is Dr. Nancy Lee, a director of product and featured in Forbes. I help hundreds of people land their dream PM job offer in FAANG companies and unicorn startup and continue to get promoted as a product leader. If you want to achieve the same kind of success, please make sure to go to this website, pmaccelerator.io, and make sure to subscribe to the channel so that you'll be notified every time we turn on a new video every Wednesday. Today, I had the pleasure to interview Nikhil from Microsoft, and he's a product manager. He has so much advice and stories like to share with all of you guys. So let's do this. So Nikhil, can you quickly introduce yourself?
Sure. Yeah. Thank you for having me over. My name is Nikhil Kuri, and I am a product manager in Microsoft in the Azure group. You know, it wasn't easy. It took me so many years to get here, and I've had my fair share of challenges getting here. I'm sure a lot of you have as well. And I'm hoping that some of the tips and advice that comes out of this session, they're helpful to you. You make notes, and hopefully you get into the dream company of yours.
So Nikhil, I love that how sincere and also how humble you are. And actually, I know one of your strengths is being able to show your product leadership and through your 30 seconds elevator pitch. Can you give us an example of your 30 seconds elevator pitch so that other people can model after you?
Sure. So my name is Nikhil Kuri, and I have over 8 years of experience as a product manager working for customer facing products across the technology industry. Most recently, I was working for a retail company in San Francisco, where I was leading their loyalty rewards program, which impacted their revenue and in a good way, caused an uptick in revenue by almost 15% and impacts more than 5 million customers. And because of that success, I was hired at an airline company here in Seattle, where I had the opportunity to build a product portfolio for their crew systems platform. So basically build products for pilots and flight attendants, which helps them fly across nationally and internationally with ease and deliver a great customer experience. And this impacts more than 10,000 of them. And in today I am at Microsoft because of my previous experiences, and I'm so glad that I joined this company. And I'm hoping to achieve more such success in this company going forward.
I love this, Nikhil. So this is why we bring you as a guest on our Influential Product Leader series. And clearly you have lots of success. And also, as you mentioned earlier, you also took you a long time to get where you are. So much impact you have made for your past client. And no wonder Microsoft love to recruit you to join their team. Even if they are announcing like hiring freeze, and even Meta announcing the layoff 10% of the employees, or big tech companies potentially going into a recession winter. But Microsoft will see you as like great talent, and they bring you on board even if some part of the company or other big tech companies start to lay off people. So there must be lots of secret you want to share with all of you guys. That's why I'm so lucky to invite you to our channel. So first of all, let's do this. Can you tell us what's your biggest challenges advancing your product career, especially help you to jump from service company to FAANG companies?
Yeah, great question. As you mentioned, I was a contractor for 8 years in the PM space. Although it gives you great exposure to the different types of industries and how product management actually functions, you get to learn a lot, but it comes with its own set of challenges, especially when you're trying to get into big tech. Well, I would say the top three challenges that I faced was getting calls from these FAANG companies, or, you know, even Microsoft for that matter. And the second one was my ability to really showcase my product skills and the impact that I have created in those service-based companies. And usually big tech companies look for scale and the and that level of impact. So you should really be able to demonstrate that. And the third challenge that I faced was I was a contractor most of my post-MBA career. And as a contractor, you are kind of restricted on how much of a roadmap you can handle and how much of influence you can have on end-to-end product delivery. So that can be a little bit of a of an issue when you're trying to explain your stories to the hiring managers. So yeah, those were the main challenges, I would say.
Yeah, I can imagine because myself was also on H1B. So lots of people like us, when we get started with our career, maybe there are not many options immediately be presented in front of us. So therefore, sometimes it may be a legit career path for us to start as a contractor to begin their product career. But later on, contractor will hit a limit. And that's why you have those challenges. Why don't we do this? Why don't you tell us how exactly you conquer all those challenges? Start from the challenge number one.
Yeah, well, the biggest challenge first was H1B. I didn't have an H1B for many years. I got lucky with the lottery and, you know, after it got approved, that initially opened up the doors. That's not really in your hand. Unfortunately, that's how the system works. But post H1B, the first challenge that, as I mentioned, was getting interview calls from these FAANG and big tech companies like Microsoft.
How did you do that?
Yeah, I think that's where the product management accelerator program was the biggest help, because I was struggling to understand where my blockers lied. So the PMA program in that regard helped me understand where I went wrong with my LinkedIn profile to begin with, because that is the first place where these recruiters and hiring managers go. So so if your LinkedIn is not right, if you don't have the right keywords to make yourself identifiable, you know, it's not of much use. And other than that, also in this program, I learned how you pitch and what you pitch to hiring managers. I think that is key. You know, if you try on your own, you may try like 100 times, 150 times, and you may have, if you have some luck, one would respond, but there's no guarantee that that would eventually convert. But there's a method to the madness is what I'd like to believe. And I think your program was really helpful to me there. So that was my biggest blocker. And I'm so glad I joined this program, because that was the first issue I addressed. And then eventually things worked out. I didn't even know how to find the right people who were hiring for product roles. So that's also another problem. So after I learned a few things in this program, I fixed my LinkedIn. I first refined my 30-second elevator pitch and made sure that it is actually sounding impactful. And I cut out the noise from it and focus on what's important. And then there's a way to look for people who are hiring on LinkedIn, and the best way is to directly approach them. Applying directly on the career portal is a hit or a miss. Usually doesn't work. I've tried it in the past. It didn't work for me. I don't want to generalize it. It didn't work for me. Instead of randomly emailing hundreds of people, I chose specific hiring managers from a certain company. For example, if I reached out to 10, maybe 5 or 6 would respond because of the pitch and what they liked on my profile. If you start interacting with those 5 or 6, maybe 2 or 3 would get back to you and would offer you an initial phone round with them. And then it's all up to you and a little bit of luck, I would say. If the phone rounds go well out of those 2 or 3, ultimately 1 would end up converting you into a full-time employee.
So basically you just like have 10, pitch to 10 hiring manager and convert to 1 offer from Microsoft. Like, fantastic. Very fast, very efficient. Thank you for sharing with us. And please share with us how you conquer your second challenge. You mentioned earlier, like, not able to stand out. So tell us more.
Yeah, so after I land an interview, the second challenge lies there. How do I showcase my product skills and the impact that I've caused? How do I make myself stand out? Because really, I am competing against the likes of people from Google or other FAANG companies or MIT or Harvard. So the question is, how do you impress the hiring manager with your skill set there? And the solution that worked for me was immense amount of practice, and I can't stress that enough. So the more you practice, the more your brain gets tuned to how to answer product sense questions, and you automatically turn on that switch when someone asks you, okay, improve this or design something, even at night. So I don't know how many mocks I took, and that's where I also took advantage of the product management accelerator program. I had a lot of buddies who I could mock interview with, and you know, that helps a lot. And you need to identify in this phase how to, again, cut out the noise. You make sure you don't ramble on with your responses and just focus, be razor sharp on your product sense and answer what the interviewer is looking for, and kind of guide them into what you are thinking and validate with them. That's how I overcame my second challenge there. And you know, when you're not aware of what you need to do after you land an interview, then it's a waste of effort. So you gotta be prepared even before you land an interview.
It's crazy. And especially for sure, I know if you fail the interview, then you cannot come back for a year, like Google. And correct. So is Meta. What about Microsoft? Do they have a freeze period?
I'm not sure if this was really my first interview with Microsoft.
So you just land an offer. Okay. Someone else, if whoever listened to this, you work for Microsoft, you know their freeze period, feel free to comment in the description of this video, because right now we just land an offer. We don't know what happened after you get rejected. But anyway, so that's good to know. Wow. Yes. So therefore, it's important to be fully prepared. You mentioned that you don't know how many preparation you have done. Can you tell us in general, in terms of, let's say, how much time you dedicated, so that we have rough idea, especially you have a full-time job. For example, you dedicate whole Sunday practice, given you don't know how many you have done, but roughly time management.
Yeah, I think I spent about 10 to 20 hours a week.
I see. So those include like studying time in the program, doing mock interviews, and just randomly thinking, how could I improve whatever the hair part. So basically you immerse yourself throughout the entire process. That's almost like, that's amazing. So basically you're in the zone.
So for people who don't know where to start, I think once they join this program, they get, it's all ready for them. They just have to start going through use cases, do mock interviews, as I said, and it really helps to keep thinking about a problem. And that really is product management. You think of your customers first, right? And how do you make their lives better? Just keep thinking. That's it. That's your practice.
Right. Awesome. I need to like really save this clip to our existing student, because you mentioned you actually study all the like 60 cases and spend lots of time understanding those, because those are the sample answers. You just need to think about what you could answer, compare yours with mine. So usually some of the students all be like, they're trying to be lazy. They say, oh, let me just do one case. I was like, all our students land offer from FAANG company. They do at least 20. Like David joined Meta, he did 40. I was like, we have library of 60. You are this little, like, do increase in numbers, or it's hard to form the product sense. I like yourself, immerse yourself in, you know, how they do this. All right. It just, I love this. Like, it's all come from like amazing hard work. And also, quick comparison regarding the time, right? So you are very intense in terms of studying and learning, right? So how long took you to land your offer?
My process started, I think, at least 6 months ahead of time. And that is before I was a part of this program.
So that's including before you joined the program. After you joined the program, how long did you land an offer?
40 days, I would say, 30 to 40 days.
That's very fast. I love this. I love this. Very efficient. Yeah. So now let me ask you this question. Can you elaborate your third challenges and how do you conquer those?
Yeah, this one's a little tricky. The third challenge, as I mentioned, was being a contractor has its own limitations. You sometimes don't have full control on the roadmap or the end-to-end execution. When interviewers asked me about my role as a contractor and, you know, why I was doing a full-time person's job as a contractor, and was that even allowed? They failed to understand that you, end of the day, you are a product manager, whether you're a contractor or a full-time employee, and product managers have to take end-to-end ownership. And the more I progressed in my career, the more handle I had on end-to-end delivery and on the roadmap. So you need to really think about what your impact points are, and, you know, try and avoid talking about stories or instances which probably did not result into a great impact. Just focus on your strong stories and, you know, double down on them.
Awesome. So I like how you turn your weakness into strengths. Basically, it is, well, just be vulnerable a little bit, which is true. Yeah. So being contractor is a weakness compared with other candidates from Harvard, MIT, or Google, like those companies.
Yeah.
But you are able to show them, hey, I'm a contractor, but allow me to learn so many different kind of product management company. Let me tell you an example. Here is the impact I made for Alaska Airlines for this and this. See, even if I don't work for full time, see how I brought in millions of dollars and revenue for them. So that's why you hire me, so that I can help you to make billions of dollars. That's an important like mindset shift and narratives in terms of like changing the dynamic within interview. I'm glad you execute strategy perfectly. That's amazing. Awesome.
Yeah.
So these lead to my next question regarding mindset, right? So I really want to understand. So what's the number one thing that it really helped you from, oh, I don't know what's going on, and boom, you just say hit it.
Yeah. So one thing I learned all these years is that interviewing is a different skill set from what you actually end up working on, because in an interview, you really have to have product thinking, and you know, think like a startup CEO, or just act like the product that you are answering to is your baby, and how would you really take it out there. Developing that thought process takes time, and also to really seal the deal and show that you are a leader in true sense, you lead the interview. It's not the interviewer. That mindset makes a lot of a difference.
I can see the confidence in you. Just like, hey, we're having a discussion about the product. You are going to work with me side by side.
Yeah.
So let me show you the thinking. And if you don't like mine, well, let's have a conversation. But I'm confident showing you I know how to get a job done. And also that's why you then offer within 40 days after applying all the like strategies, like shift it, just get it done. I love this. Can you tell us what the first 30 day look like? In Microsoft, it's a super busy, intense, or I heard Microsoft is one of the best place for work-life balance compared with all the FAANG companies. Is that true? So tell us more.
You know, the first 30 days are really getting into the grind of things. So first 2 weeks focus on orientation and getting you set up for success.
So how many people have you met in the first 30 days?
It's not even 30 days. It's my third week here. I've met about 20 to 25 people, different people, trying to understand them, where they come from, what is it that they're working on. And it's huge. And even if it's not a long-term goal, you should try and get into a big tech company, understand how it functions. I say that because I've seen how service-based companies work versus the scale that these big tech companies have. And you probably need a totally different approach here. And I joined Microsoft as a total newbie. I don't consider myself as a seasoned product manager. I'm a blank slate at this moment. I want to see how it functions.
I love how humble you are. You still see yourself as a newbie and also start to learn. Awesome. Yeah. So clearly that's the advice given from the product leader series. So that's why we have final question regarding any advice would you have for other people to jumpstart their PM career, especially join the FAANG company? This is more for people who are entry level, who want to get started, who want to break in. So what advice do you have for them?
If you are starting out, if you're not in a product management role, but if product management is something that fascinates you and you want to get into, so there's two categories: one, students, fresh graduates, and the other ones are who are already working but are not in PM roles. To address the, I'll start with the people who are already working in companies. Rather than applying to product management roles outside, try and get into product management in your existing company. Start by helping out other PMs, talk to them, set up one-on-ones, understand what they do on a day-to-day basis. Because if you ultimately realize that product management is not something you would like, then you know, you can stop right there. But for the other set of people who are maybe just fresh graduates or who have nothing to do with product management, I think at whatever stage you are in your PM career, whether it's beginner or seasoned or mid-level, you are bound to run into roadblocks at some point. And I think Product Management Accelerator Program clearly tells you what you need to do at that stage. For me, getting into a FAANG company was the major roadblock, like opening up my doors through LinkedIn or reaching out to hiring managers. You can work with Nancy. She's a great resource. She has other great resources in the program. I'm pretty sure it'll benefit you a lot, at least getting you started. And, you know, there are even folks who will advise you on your career progression there, and you can make friends and have peers who are in the same space. So I think that's one of the ways that you can get started.
Thank you so much, Nikhil. And actually, I didn't know we were going to say so much about the program. Thank you so much. And sharing with your peers, with in the community. We know you're going to speak in our alumni panel next month. I'm looking forward to hearing about the insider secret working for FAANG companies, what kind of interview question they ask you, things like that. I'm very looking forward to that part. Awesome. Okay. So everybody, if you find this product leader podcast series and very useful, please make sure to share this video and give a thumb up and comment below if there's any other questions you have for Nikhil. And we are more than happy to help you guys for free throughout this entire YouTube channel. And I want all of you guys to be successful and achieve your own definition of career success, and hopefully all of you guys is going to be one of the future product leader in the future and help others like you. Awesome. Great. So thank you very much for joining us, Nikhil, and everyone. And thank you for your time, and I'll see you guys next time. This is Dr. Nancy. See you guys. Bye.